We thought it was over earlier this year, and we were hopeful that our lives would be up and running again soon until the second wave chokeslammed us out of the blue. Just like last year, I'm sure a lot of our lives took unexpected turns owing to the dardnak return of the virus this year, and it was so much worse this time around. The world, and especially our country, was an absolute hot mess, and we could barely cope with the insurmountable anxiety that comes with struggling to stay alive in the middle of a global catastrophe. But as nature would have it, this wave gradually ceased too, and those of us who were lucky enough to survive it have become all the more cautious now. Since we were locked at home for the majority of the year, most of the big events and the trending topics were virtual. A celebrity was in the limelight for kind of the wrong reasons.
Drugs case mein film star Shahrukh Khan ke bete Aryan Khan ki raat jail mein kati.
Shahrukh Khan's son right now stands arrested.
Aryan Khan was detained along with the others after they were caught in possession of several drugs at a cruise by the NCB. Then his WhatsApp texts about having a blast were interpreted as pointing to international drug trafficking. Kuch zyada hi faltu ka blow up kar diya tha media ne isko, to be honest. For starters, it was just a way for people in power politically to show that wo kisi ko nahi chhodenge if they're caught with drugs, be it a common man or the son of the biggest celebrity in India. But because this case involved the latter, this news got incredibly sensationalized and the authorities went slightly overboard in exercising their power, I feel. Crypto gained a lot of new investors and buyers this year as more people learned about this decentralized currency, which is a risky investment but very rewarding if you're smart and experienced in trading. It's a common misconception that crypto is banned in India, but its use here is just slightly restricted as it can't be used as a medium of exchange for every single transaction. But its market here is flourishing so much that India mein 10 crore se zyada logon ne crypto mein invest kiya hai. Basically, UK and Canada ke collective population se zyada India में लोगों ने क्रिप्टो में इन्वेस्ट किया. Another public figure rose to fame and is now the national heartthrob. I mean treasure. Neeraj Chopra. It was a moment of unparalleled pride for our nation when he secured India's first track and field gold medal ever. And oh, how everyone collectively swooned over him. Even several famous celebrities such as Kiara Advani admitted to having crushes on him, while the media kept wondering if he was single or taken. NFTs or non-fungible tokens became really popular this year. These are digital assets where every token is unique and has its own value. Salman Khan, Sonu Nigam and Kamal Haasan were some of the many celebrities who jumped on the bandwagon when they found that they could make some extra shmoney on this side. Amitabh Bachchan's NFT collection where he recited his father's poetry was sold for 5.5 crores. Then there was the shortage of oxygen cylinders, which was the most mortifying event of all this year. But it was heartwarming to see how everyone came to help everyone else, be it online or offline. People gathered resources, made lists of where cylinders were available and could be procured from. Social media platforms came in extremely handy and made it possible for us to lend our hands however we could. Cricket, as usual, had a huge following this year. As this year, ek nahi but do major events the sport ke. IPL has always had a large global viewership, but the T20 World Cup, which didn't take place last year due to COVID, was held this year in UAE, where we, the host country, lost to our arch rivals Pakistan, and the whole nation mourned ek saath. As a beacon of hope, vaccines became available this year and we were finally thoda relieved. But most of us had to wait our turns kyunki age-wise vaccination ke slots scheduled the and there was a massive shortage of vaccines too, jiske wajah se the gap between your first and second vaccine was tactically increased from 6 to 8 weeks to almost 3 to 4 months. But thankfully, we're at a stage now where at least half the population of this country is vaccinated. And that says a lot because there are so many people in this country. But now scientists are saying that this vaccine doesn't provide us immunity from the brand new variant Omicron. But ab aur is saal nahi liya ja raha. So let's just hope and pray that this virus gives us a break or just leaves for good.